Hello everyone, we are going to discuss euro pound in this video, but before we move on to the actual analysis, let me know which pair you'd like to see analyzed, guys. If you have anything in mind, anything that you'd like to be covered, below in the comments, and I'll make sure I'll look into it and create another videos. Now back to euro pound. First of all, starting from weekly chart, of course, we do have the big range, which later on managed to create another range inside of it. Since that range was broken right here and the breakout managed to hold below it, and we do have the momentum, of course, we know that the weekly chart is giving us the bearish direction. That means we can drop to the lower time frames and start looking for possible sell opportunities. Now, talking about the 4-hour chart, again, we come to the idea of a range being formed here, and this is where we need to go ahead and find the best and optimal levels that we can start attacking. If we go ahead and measure the Fibos, we'll see that the 100% is coming exactly towards the top, the marked zone here, the highlighted zone, and that means the ideal scenario for us would be for the price to go ahead and reach, or at least get closer as possible to these levels here. Okay, on the 1 hour chart we can see already one false break, okay, respecting more or less the previous high here inside the range, and technically speaking, yes, we do have the opportunity to go ahead and look for these sells, but in my opinion this is not very smart here because it's very aggressive. And now the question is, why is it aggressive? Well, we're already inside the middle of the range, which means if we go ahead and break below, we don't have that much room towards the bottom for our targets. Another reason is if we go ahead and protect this breakout here aggressively, okay, with the previous swing high, we know that there is still a level above which has all the reasons to be cleared. So we're kind of exposing ourselves unnecessary and kind of forcing this trade without being too patient. I'm not saying it's not tradable, I'm just saying that for me it's too aggressive. So back to the conservative part, the ideal scenario once again would be to see the price pushing, creating another false break here, or false convergence for that matter, if it pushes in one wave very strong to the upside or something like that, and then whether it's going to be this divergence or that divergence inside the last leg, we can be looking for these entries. Now I prefer to use the lows because in my opinion this is slightly more conservative. Some people prefer to trade trend lines, but again, trend lines are more aggressive. That's why if you're going to trade the trend lines, make sure you know what you're doing, make sure you have all the extra confirmations such as levels, divergences and so on. So that's pretty much the idea. Let's see if we can get it here and then we'll start looking for the possible attacks. Of course, if you like this video, guys, please thumbs up, make sure to subscribe if you're not subscribed at that stage, and that's all. Wonderful trading. Bye for now.